Well, glory to God. Welcome to church on Father's Day 2020. How many of y'all are glad to be in the house of God? Hallelujah! Well, say it with me. Say, the Lord, He is good, and His mercy endures forever. How many of y'all come to honor the greatest Father of all? Amen. Our Father God in heaven. So I want you to just honor Him and give Him praise this morning. You can see we've got a lot of people out, a lot of people on the road. So I need everybody here to just have His way of will and His glory will be the result today in this house. Marla, just lead us in prayer.
Lord, I just thank You for allowing us to come into Your house today, God. And I thank You for a day that we can just celebrate Father's, Lord. As we celebrate You each and every Sunday and Wednesday, God, we want to celebrate those fathers that You have given us here on earth, God. And I thank You for every father that is here, Lord. I thank You for the blessing that they are to their family, God. And they are a blessing because they are in the house of the Lord. So, Lord, I ask that You just pour out abundance of blessings on them today. Make them feel loved. Make them feel wanted, God. Let them know how important they are, Lord. We ask that You just watch over this service, God. You guide it, direct it. You bend it, whatever You want to do to it, Lord, so it follows what Your will is. We just thank You. We love You. In Jesus' name, amen. Yeah. went into this whole, I feel like almost an Easter feel, because it's all about what Jesus has done for us. I mean, happy day about a God that died on the cross and rose again so that we can have this joy. And then we have holy water that's talking about what he can do for us, what he brings to us. And then Jacob's about to be by his wounds. I mean, it's just this theme, and I don't know why, but maybe it says it's Father's Day. You know, maybe God's trying to get a point to us that just as he has done stuff for us, and he constantly tries to remind us of those things, to be thankful. But not only to be thankful, to show his love to us. I think sometimes people look at it and they take in this thing of, oh, well, you're trying to shove this in my face. Tell me what somebody did for me. And I don't even know this person, but that's a choice. You can know the God that did that for you. And you can choose to love him because he's already chosen to love you. You can walk away and he still chooses to love you. So I think it's pretty awesome that God just placed this on my heart as I made this list last night, because I think he's really just trying to show his love today and tell you that he not only loves you, but if you have an earthly father that was there for you, that love is shown through him. That's what God can give you. But if you didn't, that's okay. You have a heavenly father that loves you greater than anyone can. And I believe that's what he's trying to say today.
He was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our sins. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him. And by his wounds, we are healed. He was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our sins. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him. And by his wounds, we are healed. We are healed. We are saved.
saved. He was pierced for my transgressions. He was crushed for my sins. The punishment that brought me peace was upon him. By his wounds, I am healed.
Okay. We got to sing that one again. And I want you to remember what you got saved from when you sing this part. I don't know about you, but I had a lot of deep, dark things that he picked me up out of. Out of this hole I couldn't get myself out. And he'll do the same for you. Let's just thank him for a moment. Oh, we thank you. You were pierced for my transgressions. You were crushed for my sins. The punishment that brought me peace was upon you. And by your wounds, I am healed. You were pierced for my transgressions. You were crushed for my sins. The punishment that brought me peace was upon you. And by your wounds, I am healed. And by your wounds,
the ground began to shake, to stone. We sing hallelujah, the heavens open.
Spirit of the Lord is in this house today. Hallelujah. Would you just lift up your hands one more time? Just go into the presence of God right now. Lord, we just thank you. Hallelujah. We praise you. We glorify you today. Lord, I thank you, Lord, that you have inhabited the praises of your people today. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus. We just be engulfed by who you are today. We thank you, Lord. We praise you. We thank you for everything you've given us in life, everything you've blessed us with. Father, in a natural relationship, and Lord, we thank you for the supernatural relationship we have with you. Lord, we love you this morning. We give you glory. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Somebody lift up their voice to the Lord this morning. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, we love you this morning. Oh, God, you're good. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Let's just wait on the Lord so you keep playing, too. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus.
Signs and wonders may be done by stretching forth your hand to heal.
by the name of your holy son Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Are you glad for the anointing of the Lord?
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
I don't know if you showed up. God showed up. And then I feel his presence. I feel his spirit here this morning. How many of y'all appreciate the spirit? Glory to God. Say it one time. Say the Lord. He is good. And his mercy endures forever. Amen. But you may be saved. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. And we're experiencing flow here. Amen. Have y'all got it out there?
Yes.
Glory to God. God's presence. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Everybody say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. God's good. Amen. God's good. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mary, I don't know if you had anything turned in this morning. We'll pray over needs. We prayed over needs this morning for us. We had a prayer meeting this morning. But we're going to take these names to the Lord. Be sure everything is covered today. How many of y'all know God watches over his word to perform it? Amen. And God is faithful. Amen. He's not a man that he should lie. Aren't y'all glad about that?
Hallelujah.
Has anybody ever been lied to by a human being? I don't think any of us are left out on that deal. Amen. Amen. But I can promise you one thing. God has never once lied to me. Amen. Now, it may not come to pass exactly when I think it should. But isn't it amazing how that when God has his way and it comes to pass in his timing, then all of a sudden I look back with 20/20 vision, hindsight 20/20, and say, oh God, now I understand why you didn't do it over there.
Right.
Amen? Amen? So say this, say God's timing is perfect, just like he is. Amen? And say this, his word will be accomplished. Say that till you're convinced. Say, his word will be accomplished. Say this. A matter of fact, Jesus said, it is finished. It's done. And I receive the results in Jesus' name. Amen. Give the Lord a hand. Hallelujah. For many of these we prayed for today, but we're gonna continue to pray. Let's pray for Chris and Terry for major surgery on Thursday. That's it. His family. God will just continue to minister there. Let's pray for Amanda. She's got headaches and nausea. Let's lift her up. George and Kenneth for healing today in Jesus' name. That's Crystal's family. And pray for healing for them. And also for Crystal for strength. There's many other needs going on in the body that we mentioned through our prayer time. Remember Johnny Farrell and him. Remember so many names. I'm going to try to mention the ones I can remember as well. Let's pray for Sean Schaefer, of course. Many of our folks are traveling today. Some on vacation, some going to be with fathers. But let's remember Ben and Linda. They may be back yet, they may not. Let's remember the Whitley family. Amen. And those on the road. And let's pray for healing. How many of y'all, I know we had many, many requests this morning. How many of y'all know about a situation? Either a family needs some help, or God, there's healing needed in a situation, or you need a spiritual awakening in family or someone you love. Just lift your hands to the Lord right now and represent that. The Lord knows that, amen? The Lord knows that. So aren't you glad he knows what we have need of before we ask? Now just say this, and I am confident of that scripture. If God knows what we have need of even before we ask. But Lord, you said, ask that your joy be full. You said, we have not because we ask not. So I come asking today, and I come receiving today in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Well, let's take these things to the Lord in prayer. You know, I just want you to get, I thought it was such a great testimony of what Caitlin shared this morning. How many of y'all remember last week praying for a 3-year-old girl that got bit by a virus? And I want to tell you, you don't combine those two things in a story and use it as a good outcome. Amen. That little girl is home today, and what we know, that they're managing them treating the wound now. They got the toxins out. That's a miracle in the name of Jesus. Somebody give God some praise. Amen. When we serve a miracle working God, Christ. You may or may not know what's going on in their life. Preferably look at somebody you didn't ride to church with and just tell them, I want to remind you, you serve a miracle working God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So let's access him this morning. Amen. Stand your feet with me. Let's pray this morning. This wonderful Father. Father, we just thank you this morning. We give you glory. We give you praise. We give you thanks for it. We can come into your house. God, it doesn't matter whether there's 22 or 2,000 or two. Lord, you meet us when any two or three agree is touching anything. So, Lord, I thank you for those who are in the house today. I thank you for those who are joining us online right now. And we put ourselves in agreement right now in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord, that every need we have, we bring to you in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we know that you are more than enough. You are more. You have more than enough healing. You have more than enough provision. You have more than enough encouragement. You have more than enough power to save out of every situation. So, Father, we claim your best and your blessing in every situation. We thank you, Lord, that you're touching. We thank you that you're mending right now. And Father, for every one of these situations, we trust you right now. Now y'all just pray this with me. Say, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we give you everything that is near our hearts today that we cannot change by our power. So Lord, we trust your power. Lord, perform your word. Lord, bring your full will about in this matter. And I thank you, Lord, that you said you would perfect that which concerns me. Hallelujah. And Lord, we give it to you. We thank you for it. We give you glory that it's touched in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we set these things before your feet. We take our hands off them because we trust you in the Lord. We thank you that the answers are on the way in Jesus' name. And everybody that agrees says, amen. And I agree. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a hand of praise. Glory to God. We love you. We see you in the Lord's truth. Not only we've got a thing. We don't have a big crowd this morning, but I want to tell you that you fathers are important, and we want to honor you this morning. I'd like for every dad to come up here with me and stand with me this morning. We want to just pray over you and bless you and just honor you for just a moment. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. How many of y'all are glad for fathers? Amen. Amen. Y'all just turn around and face the congregation. Amen. Fathers are a blessing. Amen. And we all agree there's no job any harder than that of the mother. Amen. Don't we agree, gentlemen? Amen. And a wife. Let me throw that in there. Amen. But let me tell you what. There is no responsibility put on anyone that is greater than the responsibility of a husband and a father.
Yes.
Amen. So these guys will have to answer for something, ladies, that you will never have to answer for to God. Amen. God's put them over their household. When it comes to children, it's a great task. Amen. To seed and to sow the word of God. And some of us did it well. Some of us, let me say this, all of us made some mistakes along the way. Can we say amen? But aren't y'all glad by the grace of God? We're still in his house in 2021.
Yes, we are.
We're still recognizing him as the ultimate help in our lives. Amen. Hallelujah. Jacob, I know it's awesome what you're having to open and be down here with these fathers. Amen. Oh, yeah, I forgot. He's wireless today. Everybody say, Jacob, lose some wires. That's good. Well, this is the right time for this today. Glory to God. Amen. Yeah. Praise God. So I thank God for these dads. I want to pray a blessing over you this morning as fathers. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for the men of this church. I thank you, Lord, there's some men sitting out of this congregation this morning. Lord, I see Gerald. But Gerald, we will be fine without the back door. Come on up. I know, brother, you're trying to do your job. But come on up here. We need you up here with us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, Jimmy, you got a minute. You can sit back there. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now, Lord, we just thank you, Father God, for the help and the anointing. Lord, I thank you that we have able men in this congregation that aren't fathers, and I pray a blessing on them because, Lord, I know that in their life, God, they have fathered many. Hallelujah. Bless Jimmy, Lord. Bless Aaron. Hallelujah. Bless those, Father God. Bless Timothy, Lord. I pray in Jesus' name your anointing be upon them today.
Yes.
And Lord, us as fathers that stand before you up here, Father, what I pray is that, God, whether our children are young, like James, or God, whether our children are old, like me and Bill, God, I pray in the name of Jesus, you'd give us the heart to father like you. Hallelujah. Let us love our children, God. Let us be anointed. Anoint Gerald, God. Anoint him to be a great father in the days and years to come. Anoint you, Father, with great heavenly wisdom. Blessing and anointing the Father. Anoint Drew, the Father, with the secrets of wisdom. Help God. Lord, anoint Nathan, God, for the timely wisdom and how, God, to do it. God, the way you want him to do it. In Jesus' name. Oh, God, anoint Bubba, and I thank you for what you're pouring into him. God, what you're going to start pouring out of me. In Jesus' name. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for what you're doing in, with fatherhood in his life this very moment.
Yes.
Glory to God. Thank you that God is healing the Father. He's healing the Father. God, I thank you for the blessing of fatherhood in Wes's life. God, I know he values it as one of the most greatest blessings in his life. So God, anoint him as he thanks you. Give him honor. He thanks you. Oh God, anoint Brother David. Thank you, Lord, for raising him up to be a great testimony to his household. God, I pray that you just put within him, God, oh, Father, the days and years to come, anoint with a backbone of steel. How that he must stand. How that when the enemy tries to make him bow. Oh, God, let the fatherhood of this man resound, Father God, to his family. Father, anoint him, Father God, with these young children. I pray in the name of Jesus with the wisdom of God, the pouring from his mouth and from his life, that they may hear, they may see, and they may desire that relationship. Father, I thank you for these men. I ask your anointing upon all of us. God, help me be the father, God, even my grown children.
Yes.
Lord, I can speak into their life. God, it will be a blessing and a help to their life. God, we thank you for the blessing of our children. We give you praise. We give you glory. And God, we pray honor and goodness upon these men today.
Yes.
In Jesus' mighty name. And everybody say, amen. And if you appreciate these fathers, would you stand and give them a hand? Hallelujah. And the song is ready. Bless you. I want to say another business for men that are out there this morning. I want to just bring honor to you too. You may not have natural children, but I want to tell you, I know what you pour into other lives. You're a witness, you don't even know it. So God bless you guys. Amen. Guys, we love you. I want to say happy Father's Day. Pastor Don is going to come and give you just a small token of appreciation to you guys and a gift today on Father's Day. God bless y'all. We love you. Give them another hand, y'all, before you see you this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Man, I tell you why I'm enjoying church this morning. I feel God here. Does anybody feel God here? Lord God, he's here. Whatever you need, God will take care of him. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Well, praise God. Well, we're going to take our offering. We're going to do something. Hey, a couple of announcements I need to make to you real quickly. I want to announce to you that this Wednesday we will have service. Everybody say, this service, Wednesday this week, prayer at 6:30, service at 7 as usual. Next Sunday we're going to have some special guests. Y'all need to be here, amen? We're having Shay and her husband Chris Gutierrez. Shay is an anointed worshiper, so you don't want to miss Shay. Shay, yeah, Shay. Actually, you heard her last name, but she's anointed, isn't she, Wes? And that's actually Jacob's cousin, so she's a great lady. She helped us out on some of the night of worships that Jacob had done. So you don't want to miss. Praise worship would be something you're going to miss. And then Pastor Randy Ayers is coming to minister next week. Him and Sister Linda. So how many of y'all believe we got a great service tonight?
Yes.
So don't miss that. I want to go ahead and tell you, as pastors of work, I'm going to be ministering in Lubbock, Texas next week. And so I won't be here, but please be faithful to this house. We need y'all to be here and support what's going on. And so please be faithful. Come and give it all you have. Bring somebody with you. We want our guest ministers to get blessed. We want you to be blessed too. So they're fired up about being here, and we want to bless them as well. Amen. So please. going to be faithful next week. Pray for us in that service. We're going to minister at West Texas Church at the Barn, Big Cowboy Church in Lubbock, Texas. And then after that, we'll be taking a break for that week. So I want to tell you that not this Wednesday we'll have regular service. There will be no Wednesday service the next week. And I'm going to have Drew share some things with you next Sunday. He will remind you of that next week. But just be praying about this week coming and here and there. It'll be great ministry going forth. And we'll see the hand of God. Yes. Amen. So remember that. And with that being the case, no early prayer meeting next week. Okay? So you can pray at home, pray on the road. Just come and be here at 10 next week for service. That sound good to anybody?
Yes.
Amen. Well, thank you. That takes care of the announcements. Now we want to pray over this offering. How many of y'all are thankful that God has blessed you?
Yes.
How many of y'all are glad that God's faithful? He watches over His word to perform it. And when you give, it's what? Giving unto you. Amen. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Show men give unto your bosom. Amen. You know, every time I turn around, I'm reminded of the blessings of God that somebody just gave me. Was in the office this morning. Ben Drew was talking. He was talking about this. Longhorn hide on the floor of my office. Man, I like this. I need to get one of these. Where'd you get this? Somebody blessed you with it. Amen. Amen. You get to look around your life and get to think about what all you've been blessed with. Amen. God takes care of His people. Hallelujah. And so I want to tell you, God will make sure all your needs are met. He will make sure that you get into blessings. Because He said, if you delight yourself in His ways, He'll give you the desires of your heart. How many of you have found out that to be true? Amen. So take your offering in your hand, whatever represents your tithe and offering this morning. Let's speak a blessing over it as we give it this morning. In Jesus' name. Say this with me. Say, Lord, I thank you. You take care of my needs. You always do. Sometimes, Lord, I don't know how you do it, but you always get it done. And Lord, I thank you that you're the God of more than enough. Now today, by faith, I give you this portion. It's my tithe and offering. And Lord, I give it with faith, knowing, Lord, that as I plant this in the house of God and in the kingdom of God, that, Lord, it releases something. It releases your blessings, Lord, upon this house, upon the kingdom, and my house. Thank you, Lord, for your anointing and blessing upon this seed. And I give it cheerfully today. In Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Come on and give us the Lord will lead you. God bless you for what you do.
Hung it in her closet.
She planned to wear it on the day she died. She told her friends farewell, I'll soon be parting. I plan to meet you on the other side. She sat down and read from the family Bible. She read the prophecies of how this world will fall. And she read what John described. She started thinking, I may not need my grave clothes. Some of these are familiar. to you, but and there's some of these songs really focus on what this day is about in the natural, and that is the relationship of the Father. Amen. How many of y'all are glad that, how many of y'all are glad that you got a heavenly Father? Glory to God. Look, I was one of those blessed ones. I had a great dad. Amen. I had a great dad. Not that he was flawless, and there was, I mean, we had some rough years just like any household. And some years I saw my dad was very confused about some things. But I want to tell you, my dad always, I knew my dad loved me. And when it really came down to it, he knew the most important thing was to show me and point me to God and the Word of God. And my dad finished strong. Hallelujah. So I'm thankful for that. My dad was a testimony of God's delivering power. God delivered him from alcohol. God delivered him from a confused state and healed our family. So many things I saw God do in his life. And so I'm thankful for the dad I had. Now, maybe you had a good dad. Maybe you didn't. But isn't it good to know when you come into the family of God, you got the best dad.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. The Father God is there. And man, he has a way of just making all things work together for good. Amen? But you know, in my own life, because I look at my life, you know, there were times when I wasn't exactly where I should have been. Amen? And God had a plan for my life, but I didn't always want to listen. Anybody been there?
Yeah,
man. Amen? And, you know, I was saved at 10 years old, truly saved. Baptized at 10, filled with the Holy Ghost at 15. You'd have thought I knew better. But then just a few years later, Mark Griffin started wanting to have his own way. Right. Amen? And but thank God the Holy Ghost never left me alone. Amen? He always tugged at my heart to get me back where I needed to be. And so I'm so thankful. I'm so thankful that God never gave up on me.
Yeah.
Is anybody here glad that God never gave up on you?
Yeah.
Amen. I am. And so I want to just sing another song that's one of my favorites. These next three are Dale Way songs. We love Brother Dale Way around here, and I love his writing. But this is one that can really be all of our testimonies in a way. So I hope you will enjoy this one. You'll probably know it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Well, I thought I could make it all alone.
Save your soul. I've been a little wrong since my name.
Lamb's blood on
it.
Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Well, I'm having fun with somebody else. Glory to God. Does minister to anybody out there? You know, before we do this next song, I just want to share the truth with you. And it is this. You know, with all that Jesus did for us, all the Father prepared for us, it's really hard to go to heaven. Amen?
Amen.
Man, God made every provision for us to avoid it. In fact, He never created it for any human being anyway. I mean, y'all know that. It was created for the devil and his angels. Amen? But we messed it up. Everybody say, we messed it up. I'm talking about mankind, Adam and Eve in the garden. We sinned, we disobeyed God, allowed sin in, so everything changed. The curse came. But it had to stay like that. Yes, we deal with that human nature, but Jesus came to do away with the curse, because those that accept Him have a new nature. Amen? The character and nature of Jesus Christ. And His mercy and His grace, you say, yeah, but my strength is small. I'd be a Christian, but I know I'm going to fall. Well, welcome to the club. Because we all are human and we make mistakes. The difference is, when you're a Christian, the Holy Ghost is abiding in you, and you know it when it happens. So you ask God to forgive you. You get up, you determine not to do that again, and you keep doing that until that thing is gone and out of your life. And God perfects you. He works a perfecting work in your life as we desire to please Him because of all He's done for us.
Amen.
So I want to tell you, I'm not going to make that decision, amen, to allow anything to keep me from heaven. I've chosen Jesus, and I'm going to stay the course. Is anybody with me on that this morning? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Well, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So this is, I love this song. Find words as we've all discovered today. I need words. Thank you, Lord. Look at somebody and say, you are blessed today in the name of Jesus.
You're blessed today in the name of Jesus.
How are you?
How are you? Thank you, sir.
EQRST. Somebody set up testify while I'm trying to find myself up here. Go ahead. I got two. Y'all go ahead, both of
them. Go ahead. Well, I was just saying the same, really, but you know what? I'm going to tell you right now, man. I'm thankful that God has shown me revelation this week, some more revelation, and it keeps me humble. And that's a nice place to be.
Yeah, glory to God. Glory to God. Amen. Anybody knows what's going on? We don't, Bruno.
You know what? When it comes to being a father, I don't always know the right thing to do, but what I learned with mine, I know what not to do. And I had a conversation with Mark on the way to church this morning. Make sure you let me know I'm doing the right thing.
Yeah.
Mark did his birthday party yesterday, and he got $100 from his friend. First thing, we got the
truck
this morning. He asked me how tight it was.
Glory to God.
And then a little more tight on his $100 this morning.
Yeah, hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Isn't that good? I love that.
That's the story I'm going
to read for. Yeah, yeah. Train them to try the way they should go. Amen. Praise God. Somebody give God thanks. Amen. Good Father's Day story. Amen. Praise God. All right, I think I got this figured out. We'll go. Did you have something else to do?
No.
Well, you just keep thinking. About life,
convince myself giving up would be all right. Then Satan whispers, just take the path of yesterday. The cross standing in the way. The cross stands between me and forever. The road to hell only leads to Calvary.
Oh, excuse me.
There we go. Alright. Hallelujah. Everybody say, psh. Jacob didn't tear his mind. You know, I suppose that there's one story I could pick out of the Word of God to really think about fathers and what they feel like. It would have to be the story of the prodigal son. Father never gave up his love for that son. Let him go. Amen. Let him go take his field and his inheritance. Do all that he wanted to do for himself. The thing that always stood out to that story to me was the son, you know, went and all, he spent all his money, his inheritance on evil living, drinking, wild living, prostitutes, you name it. And a famine hit that land. And he had to go to work for a pig farm. He's there working, feeding the pigs. It says his belly was hungry even for the pigs' food because times were so tough. He was there in the mud. And then he said, I love the scripture where it says that, but he came to himself. Have any of y'all ever experienced like I have a moment when you come to yourself? And you say, why am I here? When there is more than enough feeding and love and provision. My Father. Speaking of spirits, I don't know what I'm talking about.
Amen.
And the son left and he said, I'm going to go back to my father and tell him I've wasted it all. I want to come back as a servant. He said, I'll be happy just as a servant. And as he was coming, this is what I love. This is my favorite part of the story. It says the father saw him coming from afar off. You know what that tells me? We don't know in the story how long it took. It may have been a couple of years. It may have been 15 years. But that tells me that every day that the father didn't run out and go looking for the son and try to force him to come back. Amen? But the father was there. And it tells me that every day that father was in his house praying, going about his work, but every day he was looking down that road. Expecting, everybody say expecting, that
one day,
he would see his son return.
Amen.
Well, when he did, the father did not stay put, but he ran to meet his son. And the son ran to meet him. And they embraced. He said, Father, I've sinned. I've spent all of my inheritance. And I'm so sorry. Can I come back and just be a servant unto you? And the father picked him up, hugged him, and wiped his tears off his eyes. And he called the servants. He said, hurry, bring a robe, bring a ring, kill the fatted calf, because my son has returned. Hallelujah. I remember the day over the little broke down church in McGregor, Texas, that a man preached the anointed word of God. And I ran back home to my father, God. And he embraced me. He filled me with love and changed me again forever. You see, I'm one of those that I know what it's like to get saved. I know what it's like to be full of this. And I know what it's like to turn your back on it. Try to embrace sin and play mind games. God's okay with this. I don't know what I'm talking about. But then come to myself one day and confronted with the Word of God and say, God, I need you more than I need what I want. And man, I found out the love of God. That day was just as important to me as the day I said yes to Jesus. And it changed my life forever. I'm so glad that the Father didn't give up on me. Didn't lock the gate, put a padlock on me. Amen. But he kept looking for me, kept dealing with me, knowing that one day, believing that one day, I would walk down that path back to him in communion and fellowship with him. I'm glad about that. Is any of y'all glad about that?
Yes.
This is a tough song to do, not just because it's a raise your kids back in as they come with us. Not just that it's a deep meaning song, moving song, but it's a tough song to sing. So I hope that I do it justice. And this song was written by a man named Benny Hester, and also another writer was John Parent. But Benny Hester was from Waco, Texas. And Benny Hester went to Richfield High School. Y'all remember Richfield High School? Brother Dave, I mean, you had to be around here a long time to remember Richfield High School. But I remember Richfield High School. You're not the only one, remember that? But listen, this is what's funny. Benny Hester, my dad had a band, dance band back then. And he went and played in all these dance halls and stuff. We're using our music for the right reason, but we're living for dollars. But Benny Hester did that, played the accordion, and dad went and played in all these check halls. So Benny Hester was part of my dad's band for a short time, playing the accordion. But that's just a friend story. This is what it's neat about. Benny Hester got saved, went to Nashville, and in the 80s, Benny Hester was was a premier Christian contemporary artist. And this was probably one of his greatest songs. And it's a song I love. Hope I do it justice to minister to you today.
With forgiveness in his voice, he said, "Son, do you know what?"
I just thank you this morning. I thank you for your spirit. I thank you that you're present here with us today. Father, I just thank you, Lord, for this time that we've had to visit who you are in us. Father, I thank you, God, that I would not be standing here today if you had given up on me. So, Father, I thank you. God, you're the God of second chances, third chances, fourth chances, fifth chances, 777 chances. Father, I ask you today, God, if there's anybody listening to my voice that would say in their heart, I know I'm not home. I know I'm not home with God. I need to be. But today, I want to go there. Or maybe there's some that's never been there. And God, they want to come home as adopted sons, coming down that road for the very first time. And maybe there's others like me that, Lord, walked away from that fellowship but came back. Father, I pray today calling of God to draw your children to you. And I pray, God, that some would find your presence and your arms open wide to welcome us. With that being said, I'm going to just ask if you're here today and you'd say, you know what, Pastor, I'm ready to come home to the fullness of where God wants me to be. There's things I've walked away from, but I'm ready to run home into the Father's arms. If that's you, come here right now. Stand with me. I want to pray with you in Jesus' name. Come on, if that's you right now. What an opportunity for God. What an opportunity for you. Hallelujah. Is there anyone here today? Hallelujah. We'll say that's me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. God loves you so much. Hallelujah. He's running to you right now. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Who's going to join up with us today? Hallelujah. Thank you, Aaron. Hallelujah. God love you. God love you. Step on up here, God. Hallelujah. Step on up here. Who's going to join? Hallelujah. Who's going to join? I know you may have things going on. You say, man, I can't do this. You're right. You can. That's why you need God. You need God's help. Amen. Would you run to the Father this morning and meet me? Hallelujah. Say, that's me. That's me. I want to go down that road. I want the Father's hand around me. Maybe like it once was, maybe like it's never been. This morning, I want the Father's embrace to be fully on my life. Anybody else? Quickly. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, God. We're going to pray for these men. Jacob, could you come? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God, glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise your holy, holy name. Hallelujah. Would y'all just pray with me right now, everybody? Just say this out loud. Say, Father, thank you for these moments in time. When you show up where we are and we get a good glimpse of ourselves. Thank you, Lord, for always loving me when I'm lovable and when I'm unlovable. Lord, I thank you for your mercy today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you guys to just pray this with me this morning because I know your heart. Amen. I appreciate you. Drawn out of the Father this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. And I'll tell you, God knows your struggles. I want both God and you guys to know that God knows your struggles. You know what? The devil tries to take those things. He tries to constantly, don't get me wrong, he tries to constantly disqualify you. Yes. And convince you you're disqualified before God. The devil's a liar. Amen. The devil's a liar. The devil's after you guys because there's so much of a purpose in life. Amen. Because every time you stand on the thing.
things of God, you stand for what is right, you convert brains to the people who know them. That's not natural. Amen. That's not the natural way. That's not the way they were. Amen. That song was saying, you know, that one should just revert back to yesterday. But yesterday over. Amen.
Yes.
I'm telling you guys, I've experienced too much in God for it to be just a vibe. Amen. God has your heart. I know that.
Yeah.
So now we're just going to help you, brothers and sisters, to pray for you. And I want you to know that God's heart is so towards you today. And He's going to help you with everything you're facing right now. And He's going to be so close to you like the prodigal son story. I'm telling you, y'all got so pleased that you just take that another step forward for Him today and you put God in party mode. Just like the prodigal son. And He said, oh, I'm so proud of Aaron. Man, let's have a party and celebrate. And just walk a hard up step toward me in another way. Another day. Amen. Pray for you guys. Amen. Don't pray this way the first time. Let me get some men up here and stand behind them. Hallelujah. Just say this one. Say, Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for loving me and for today. Thank you, Lord, that you have taught me what a real father is. And I thank you for loving me as your child. God, everything that has tried to pull me away, I renounce it in Jesus' name. It has no life. It has no power. But I proclaim, I stand before this congregation today, I'm a child of God. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. But I know it's the power of God unto salvation for me. So Lord, forgive me. Every time I've blown it, every time I've failed, wash me today by your blood, and I commit to you, Lord, in a greater way than ever before. I run home to you as a servant, but thank you, Lord, to you, I'm your son today, restored. Everything is restored, and I thank you for it in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you for these men. I pray for Aaron in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Lord God, that where he is weak, you are strong. I thank you, Father God, that you have begun a good work in him. And as Philippians 1:9 says, or 1:6 says, that God, that work which you have begun in him, you will continue to perform until the day of Jesus Christ. I proclaim over him in Jesus' name, Father God, that he be anointed, that there be a passion arise within him like never before. Father, you have a passion for your word. You have a passion for your presence. And I thank you, Father God, that he sees the value of what you are. Thank you for giving him a hunger for you. And thank you, God, for his continued step toward you. And God, what you're doing for him today. Thank you, God. He's one of your children. He's blessed. Everybody say, bless Aaron in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we pray for Bubba. I thank you, Father God, the Lord, he's been through many storms and you brought him through. He's been through many obstacles, God, that the enemy has set a trap for him. Father, even though he's fallen some, I thank you that he stands upright today before you. He stands coming before you, and as he comes, Lord, he kneels before you, but now you picked him up, Lord. Just like that story, you wipe his face, you embrace him, and you let him know how proud you are of him. God, I pray you anoint Bubba with such great love, such great forgiveness, such great anointing, that he goes forward, Father God, with the radiance and glory of God. Give him strength, give him grace with his words, with his life, and anoint him, God, be stronger. Thank you, Father, for this anointed son. Bless him in your kingdom. And I thank you for it. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Somebody give the Lord a praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to praise. Hallelujah. We thank the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to your holy name. Thank you, God. Love you. Be seated. Well, I hope this has been a blessing. It amazes me how long you just embrace the Holy Spirit, His Word, whatever the form. He shows up. He works in the hearts of men.
Yeah.
Amen. He's so good to me. Won't you stand with me before we dismiss this love on you one more time? All right, if you're thankful that you're a child of God, you're home with Him, maybe just thank Him one more time. Lord, we love you, God. We praise you. We glorify you. We thank you, God, for your goodness, for your love, for your tender mercies toward us today. We give you praise, Lord, for what you've done. God, what you're doing. Father, we pray for those who are watching online today. We ask in the name of Jesus for those that watch, God, that Lord, need to make a change. I pray right now, even as we pray for Bubba and Aaron, God, I pray if there's those that were just shoring up their place in you, I thank you, Lord, right now, your mercies are extended toward them as they call out to you. You're doing that. I thank you for those who may have received the tug of the Holy Spirit for the very first time and need to be saved. I thank you in the name of Jesus that right now, as they call out to you, Lord, and ask you to forgive them of their sins and come into their heart and wash them and walk with them. I thank you, Lord, your word says you receive them. And just like we sing about today, when they do that, their name will be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Lord, I thank you for that. Bless them. Help them, God. Lord, we just give you glory for what you've done. Lord, we thank you for these fathers. We thank you for this special day for them. Now bless them as we go. Give us all a great day of fellowship with our families, with one another. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name. And everybody say, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Say this to me. Say, I leave this place today anointed by the Holy Ghost, empowered by the Word, and covered in the blood. God bless you. Thank you for being in church today. Happy Father's Day once again. Go have a blessed Monday and Tuesday and Wednesday. We'll be back here for church. 6:30 prayer and 7:00 service. Don't forget our special guest next week. Come and have a great time here in the house of God. God bless y'all. Go with the Lord. We'll see you on Wednesday.